By the way, I've done something bad. I didn't introduce Vi. Vi is here because she's chair of transportation and planning now, and I'm a co-chair for the city. So just so you know, we're all up here to answer questions about the system in general, but I wanted you to know, make sure you know why Vi was up. It's part of conversations, so Vi, I apologize.
I think we're really struggling to make sure that that works. And it's one of those things that's that balance, and we obviously, in that case, missed the balance. So thank you for riding transit. That's what we want on the buses. We want people to have this opportunity. And if we're not doing that every day, we need to know and have that feedback. So thank you.
One of the things that you got it, so if you want to use a business model, you also along the way, when you're not getting the type of workforce you need to invest. This is all about investing in the workforce of the future. It's about connecting people. So occasionally you have gone up on things when you had to in a business because that's just the way inflation and things work. So when you have something that's important to the economy is mass transit, which is about connecting people. By the way, I think the number is, if I help me, that people who are poor, when they can actually take the bus, it's like putting $5,000 back in their pocket from not having to keep a car up and gas and some other things. I mean, this has a ripple effect all the way across the community. So this is one of those things, John, that we have got to invest in, because if we're not doing this, we're not helping the workforce that has to get the jobs. We're not helping the workforce that needs to get the training and all the things you have to do to be a better person. And you're not preparing for the future, because people are not going to continue to move to Charlotte if we don't have something as simple as a mass transit system. We'll be less competitive than other cities vying for the same jobs over the next 20 years if we don't invest in this right now. The other thing you should know is that just in the last year, we have actually, the price tag on just this one project that we invested in went up $30 million. So every time we're not investing right now, we're adding to the cost of the same project we have got to do in the future. So that's my take.
I have appreciation for that, because it's one of our several choices. When you think about what a community stands on, transportation is one of the key things to have real stability in a community. We have to have transportation choices. So just like we're looking at our water and sewer system, just like we're looking at stormwater, we've got to figure out how transportation works for our community. And that's why I think all of those areas are strapped. I think when we get elected, we are responsible for figuring out that balance of what we're going to have to do. I don't think transportation, especially transit, should be singled out as something to be said, well, why can't we stay within that category when we really have to look at the overall city balance? So I think that it is a difficult place to be right now. Some of our community is strapped, but some parts of our community are doing exceptionally well. And that's because we have a workforce. We have people that come here for jobs. So if they come for jobs, we've got to get them. You know, not everybody's going to make $70,000 a year. When that person is making a family combined income of $50,000 and they're spending $5,000 on a vehicle, don't we have a responsibility, just like we provide roads at a huge cost to us, why can't we provide transit so that they can have a choice and we can provide workers for people that come here with jobs? So I look at it as a way that we do it all, and we have to do it in a balanced fashion. Sometimes we don't have the money to do everything, but we ought to continue to move everything forward, because that's the goal, to have us be as a city.
Well,
he doesn't make any difference at all.
yeah, I didn't say that. If there was one place where we're struggling, period, and maybe it just exacerbated, is at the state level. That relationship was not the best while he was here and while we were all here. I think it continues to be that way, not just with Charlotte, by the way, but with all urban areas. So there are places where his name carries a lot of weight. And there are places that matter right now, to be honest, with what we're trying to do. And there are places where we don't talk about it as much. And there will be probably Raleigh. That's probably the only place.
I find it remarkable that the state wants to tell us that we can't move a monument and yet won't give us authority to finance things that make the community work. It's just baffling to me.
But we want to work with them.
We are a rule-dominated state, and we're continuing to be.
But we want to work with them.
We try to coordinate with CMS as much as we can. There is limitations. There's some federal rules regarding the transporting of students because CMS has its own fleet. CMS actually has a fleet of buses that's even larger than ours, much larger than ours. Where we have good service, where the schools are located along major thoroughfares, where we have high frequency routes, some of the students are certainly able to use those opportunities, but it's more difficult when you start getting out into the far suburbs to be able to get the kind of frequency and the timing that's needed. And so what we have to do, talking back about managing our costs, we look at all of our bus routes, all of our system routes, and we examine them multiple times each year to make sure that they're operating as efficiently as possible and that we are maintaining that efficiency so that we are meeting the standards we've set. If we aren't meeting those efficiency, we have to adjust and adjust those routes. So some of those, it's just not viable to be able to make that access, but where we can, we certainly try to do that.
Also added that, I think that's a great question, and I actually think that's something the school board ought to be deciding, because a lot of times it's just that when you have a huge commitment to a large fleet, you may not be willing to actually say, what can I do differently, or can I do it in a different way? And I think there's suburban, there's urban, but my daughter, most of you know, lives in D.C., and I went up with her, we got on the bus, there were kids with their parents on the regular city bus going towards another location that they caught another school bus. So there is some ways that, actually Pat McCrory suggested this when he was mayor, and it went absolutely nowhere. So I don't know what the synergies are, but I think it would require the school board to say, we're willing to do it.
So there are a couple things. When I got appointed to the planning commission 13 years ago, the very first question I asked was that. One of the things that the planning staff pointed out is that Charlotte did something very unique to most cities. We put our airport close to our center city. If you go to Atlanta, you have to drive 20, 25 minutes. From downtown Charlotte to the airport is 10 minutes, 15 even in traffic. So one of the problems that we have is that the financing sources that we have, new stars, small stars, they all account on ridership. And right now, our airport is so much more about people commuting here, connecting someplace else. There's not a lot of traffic. And by the time you get on a train to go all the way out to the airport, you get a taxi and be there in 10 minutes. It's $20. One of the problems that we have is that from an economic standpoint, it's still cheaper to catch and faster to catch a taxi than to get on a bus, get on a train to go out there. Now, will it stay that way forever? I don't know. One of the things that we have done is already done the alignment that goes that way. So if you go out Wilkinson Boulevard and pass those green buses, they're called the Sprinter buses. The Sprinter buses actually are stopping at the exact spots where a future streetcar will stop. So right now, the streetcar is important. Everybody fusses about it running east and west. Eventually what it does is goes down to Cedar Street off of Trade Street. It spurs off, goes over to Moorhead, and takes that route straight out to the airport. That is the same line that will take you to the airport, the one that we're building right now, the Gold Line. It'll eventually have a spur that goes off. So those plans are in place to do fixed rail out to the airport. But right now, economically, and correct me if I'm wrong, Tina, David, the ridership is not there to justify the federal government giving us half the money it would take. And you saw the model. That's the way that model is set.